Welcome to this video on non-linear correlation metrics. I've tried searching the internet in YouTube but did not find one. So you might see the world's first non-linear correlation metrics in this video. I will start the video with the widely used linear correlation metrics and tell you on why it may not be effective in certain cases. I will then demonstrate on how a non-linear correlation metrics looks like. This will also show you the importance of analyzing non-linear relationship in the data. I'll be demonstrating with examples and visuals, and there is no theoretical PowerPoint, neither there is any complex programming screens. At the end of the video, I will show you on how you can access the demonstrations in this video and customize it to your data using the channel's website experiencedatascience.com. With this website, you can also make beautiful metrics which is shown just behind me with just a few clicks and use it as a backdrop for your presentations or virtual meetings. So let's get started, but do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. The data which we'll be using in this video is related to cars. This data has got the brand name of the car, different technical characteristics such as the fuel type, the length of the car, the width of the car, number of doors, etc., etc., as well as the price of the car. This data has got about 25 fields, and out of which there are about 15 numeric fields. When you have a very high number of numeric fields, it is useful to see if there are any relations or patterns between these fields. And one of the most common ways to do this is to use the linear correlation metrics, which is shown on the screen. In this linear correlation metrics, the X and Y axis corresponds to the numerical fields in the data. The color of the cell is an indication of the correlation between the fields. Darker is the color, higher is the linear correlation. We see here a dark red color in the cell for the correlation between engine size and weight of the car. So this means as the engine size increases, the weight of the car also linearly increases. Now let us see if this is true or not by looking at the scatter plot between the two fields. In the scatter plot, which is shown on the screen, the engine size is on the X and the weight of the car is on the Y. Looking at the dots in the scatter plot, we see that for the engine size between 60 and 200, there is a linear increase in the weight. But after the engine size of 200, the weight does not increase linearly, but it is leveling. So this means that the relation between engine size and weight is not strictly a linear relationship. We can confirm this by plotting a linear line on this scatter plot. And we see that the dots follow the linear line till about the engine size of 200, but after that, the linear line is way away from the points. Now let us try to fit a non-linear line, and one of the non-linear lines is called a third degree parabolic line. We see that this non-linear line tends to capture the trend more correctly compared to the linear line. So a linear correlation matrix is a good start but may not represent the relations accurately. It is for this reason we also need a non-linear correlation matrix. So here is how a non-linear correlation matrix looks like. On the y-axis, you have the different combinations of the fields. And on the x-axis, you have the first column as the linear relation, and then you have different types of non-linear relations. The most common type of non-linear relations are exponentially decreasing relation, exponentially increasing relation, logarithmic, second degree parabolic, and third degree parabolic. The color of the cell indicates how well the non-linear relation fits the data. Darker is the cell, higher is the non-linear correlation. Let us take the top 50 values. We see that the curb weight and the engine size, the third degree parabolic color is more darker than the linear one, which confirms that the third degree parabolic is more suitable than the linear correlation. Another example is the correlation between the horsepower and the peak RPM. In this case, the exponentially decreasing correlation is better suitable compared to the linear correlation. As a side note, let me mention that you might be looking at the world's first non-linear correlation matrix. As per my research, I did not see this anywhere else. You can also change the color of the matrix and make it look stunning. Now let me show you how you can access the demonstration shown in this video as well as customize it to your data. So first of all, start by going to this website, experiencedatascience.com, and log in. You will require a Gmail account. So once you are logged in, you can go to this section, which is titled as hands-on and a code-free experience. And this experience on the nonlinear correlation is available over here. So you can go inside it and you will see a list of video tutorials. So you can follow all these video tutorials and you will be able to get a nonlinear correlation matrix. So you'll start by a brief introduction followed by data setup, as well as you'll also calculate a linear correlation matrix. You'll also do some advanced stuff such as nonlinear curve fitting, as well as at the end you'll calculate the nonlinear correlation matrix. The complete experience is completely hands-on and code-free. So you do not require any programming skills in order to execute this experience. Now, if you want to customize this experience to your data, you can go back to the section which is titled as Work with Your Data, and you can upload your data and you can have the entire experience of nonlinear correlation, which is customized to your data. Now, let me rapidly show you on how to get the beautiful looking nonlinear correlation matrix. So first of all, go and click on this data sets and play data sets. So you will see this play_cars_data.csv. So select it and then copy it to your data. So in a while, you will see this success message. So once you have the success message, go ahead and click on data sets and your data sets. And you will see this cars data set, which is now available to you, and you can execute all the possible analytics. So select it. Click on analytics. You'll see a list of various analytics, and what we can do is you can go to this nonlinear correlation matrix. You'll see a list of numeric columns, so select all of them. Select output privacy setting as shareable and then click run. So in a while you'll see a success message as well as the nonlinear correlation matrix. So we can just click here to expand it. You can do various things. You can select the top, for example, the top 50 nonlinear correlations, and then you can also play with the colors. So you can choose the color to your liking. So you can use this beautiful looking visualization either in your presentations or as a backdrop for your virtual meetings. All right, my friends, hopefully you enjoyed the video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel, like and comment the video.